Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to add a gradient to live typable text in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, first let's go to Create New. We'll come up here to Print, and I'll choose Letter, and then we'll Create. Okay, now first I'm going to type some text. I'll hit T on my keyboard, and I'll just type text. I'll get on my selection tool and make it a lot bigger. Holding shift, by the way. And then I'm just going to change my font to Montserrat, which is one of my favorite fonts. And now I'll bring up my gradient tool. Now, normally when you click this like this, you'll see the gradient applied here, and it'll also be applied on your text. But that's not happening right now. And it's because of your appearance palette. If you're not seeing your appearance palette, go ahead and open it under Window. It's right here. When Illustrator makes an appearance, there are two sections, type and characters. Characters, if we double click it, you can see the fill down here. But with effects and gradients, we really want those up here in type. And we can't just move it like this, it won't allow that. So we have to delete it. Then we'll come up to type, and then we'll add a new fill. And you can see characters down here, and now this fill is underneath type. So now we can click on gradient and it'll apply it to our text. Let's go ahead and change this to a radial gradient. If you find that you can't add a gradient to text, it's because it's in characters instead of type. So you need to move it out of there, delete it out of characters, and add it to the fill. Now we can also create a gradient stroke. So I'm going to hit T and type stroke. We have the same problem. I'm going to double click characters and remove that fill. I'll come up to type and we'll add a new fill. And I'll click this again. And this time I'm going to switch the fill and the stroke so we have a stroke only. I'll increase the size of it so you can see what I mean. And now we can just change the color. I'll double click this slider and I'll just change this to blue. And then double click this one and change it to green. So now we've got our gradient stroke on typable text too. So we can type in here now and still maintain that gradient. So anyway, it's a good idea to, when you're building effects in your appearance and different fills and strokes, it's always a good idea to just get them out of characters and put everything into the type area. All right, if you like my style of teaching, I actually have a few full courses out on Skillshare. And if you're a member over there, you can watch those for free. If you're not, I've got a referral link for 2 free weeks, and that's in the description below, so just check that out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.